How are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing well. Myself, Shweta Mal, is here to teach you class 7th biology. We started with the chapter photosynthesis and respiration in plants. And in our last class, we studied about photosynthesis. Today, we are going to start about respiration. We eat food to get energy. You know this, that we eat food to get energy. But how do you think this food gives energy? The food that we can eat gets converted to energy that is utilized by a body by a process that is called as respiration. And we know that the food is broken down into glucose during digestion, and this glucose gets further converted to energy. What happens? This glucose gets further broken down in the presence of oxygen to release energy, carbon dioxide and water in the body, and the energy is used by all the cells of body to perform various life processes, and this process is called respiration. So what is respiration? Respiration is the process of releasing energy by breaking down that is food, that is glucose, for life activities. So as I told you that all living organisms, that is plants as well as animals, need energy for various activities like growth of a plant and absorption of water and minerals from the soil. Living organisms get this energy by a process that is called as respiration. So what is respiration? The process of breakdown of food, that is glucose, to release energy needed for various activities is called respiration. What I told, what is respiration? The process of breaking down of food, that is glucose, to release energy needed for various activities is called respiration. A small amount of energy is released during the breakdown of glucose in the form of heat. What happens? A small amount of energy is released during the breakdown of glucose in the form of heat, and a large amount of energy is stored in high energy molecules called adenosine triphosphate, that is ATP, adenosine triphosphate. And when the cells need energy to do work, ATP releases the stored energy. How does it release the stored energy? ATP, it gives ADP, adenosine diphosphate, plus inorganic phosphate and plus energy. What I told you? I told you that a small amount of energy is released during the breakdown of glucose in the form of heat, and a large amount of energy is stored in high energy molecules that is called as adenosine triphosphate, ATP. And when the cells needs energy to do work, this ATP releases the stored energy. Clear? ATP gives ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate, plus inorganic phosphate and plus energy. Now let us know about the stages of respiration. In all living organisms, the process of respiration takes place in two stages. In every living organism, the process of respiration takes place in two stages, that is external respiration or breathing, and internal respiration or cellular respiration. What I told you that in all the living organisms, the process of respiration takes place in two stages, that is external respiration or breathing and internal or cellular respiration. Now let us know about external respiration or breathing. What is this? This is a physical or mechanical process of respiration. It is a physical or mechanical process of respiration. It involves breathing in oxygen-rich air and breathing out the carbon dioxide-rich air, and the process of breathing is called as inhalation. What is the process of breathing called? The process of breathing is called as inhalation, and while breathing out is called as exhalation. Exhalation. The process of breathing in is called as inhalation, and the process of breathing out is called as exhalation. We breathe in, we breathe out. We breathe in, am I right? And we breathe out. So the process by which we breathe in is called as inhalation, and by which we breathe out is called as exhalation. Clear? Now let us know about internal or cellular respiration. What is internal or cellular respiration? So we were talking about internal or cellular respiration. This stage of respiration takes place within the cell. Where does it take place? It takes place within the cell, and it is a biochemical reaction. What it is? It is a biochemical reaction. It causes breakdown of glucose with the help of oxygen into carbon dioxide, water and energy. And how can we represent it? We can represent the cellular respiration with the help of a chemical reaction, that is C6H12O6, that is glucose plus oxygen O2 gives carbon dioxide CO2 plus H2O, that is water and energy. Let us see. Yes, so I told you that internal or cellular respiration takes place within the cell, and it is a biochemical reaction, and it causes breakdown of glucose. What it causes? It causes the breakdown of glucose with the help of oxygen into carbon dioxide, water and energy. Let us see how. C6H12O6. What is this? This is glucose. When it combines with oxygen, that is O2, oxygen, it gives carbon dioxide CO2 plus H2O, that is water, and plus energy. So energy is released. Now let us balance it. Glucose C6H12O6, 6O2 plus 6CO2, okay, plus 6H2O, and how much energy is released? Energy is released 38 ATPs. Okay, clear? Now let us see some important points regarding the reaction that is involved in cellular respiration. So we were talking about some important points regarding the reaction that is involved in the process involved in cellular respiration. The first one is the oxygen which is needed for the process of respiration or breaking down of glucose comes from inhalation. What I told? The oxygen which is needed for the process of respiration or for breaking down of glucose, this oxygen, from where does it comes from? It comes from inhalation, and this reaction shows the oxidation of glucose molecules. What does this reaction shows? This reaction shows the oxidation of glucose molecules. During respiration, the glucose is broken down to release carbon dioxide, water and lots of energy as byproducts, and the reaction is the result of a series that are controlled by different enzymes, and the energy released in the reaction is in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate, and ATP is an energy rich chemical substance that gets stored in the cells and can be broken down by any time to release energy. So these molecules are energy reservoir of cells and are used for various metabolic activities, and we can say in other words that the process of respiration involves the breakdown of food materials, that is glucose, to ATP molecules, carbon dioxide and water in the presence of oxygen. What I told? We can say that the process of respiration involves the breakdown of food materials, that is glucose, to ATP molecules, carbon dioxide and water in the presence of oxygen. And the process of external respiration is different in plants and animals. However, cellular respiration is similar in all the living organisms. Now, let us know about the site of respiration. The process of respiration takes place partially in the cytoplasm and partially in the mitochondria of the cell. Where does the respiration take place? What is the site of respiration? The process of respiration takes place partially in the cytoplasm and partially in the mitochondria of the cell. So, its site is what? Cytoplasm as well as mitochondria. Now, let us know about types of respiration. So, we are going to know about types of respiration. Depending on the presence of and absence of oxygen, living organisms shows two types of respiration. These are aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. What I told that depending on the presence or absence of oxygen, the living organisms show two types of respiration: aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. What is aerobic respiration? Most of the higher animals respire through aerobic respiration. This type of respiration results in the breakdown of glucose molecules in the presence of oxygen. It results in the formation of carbon dioxide and water and energy, that is 38 ATP. And aerobic respiration causes complete oxidation of glucose molecules. How it can be shown? It can be shown like glucose, that is C6H12O6 plus oxygen gives carbon dioxide plus water plus energy, that is 38 ATP. Thus, complete oxidation of one molecule of glucose releases 38 ATP molecules, that is 38 adenosine triphosphate molecules. Now, let us know about anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration, most of the lower organisms such as bacteria and fungi shows anaerobic respiration, and this type of respiration leads to the breakdown of glucose molecules in the absence of oxygen. Incomplete oxidation of food molecules or food material, that is glucose, leads to the formation of ethyl alcohol or lactic acid, carbon dioxide and two molecules of ATP. And how it can be shown? It can be shown as glucose gives ethyl alcohol plus carbon dioxide plus energy, that is 2 ATP. Okay, what I told you that in aerobic respiration causes complete oxidation of glucose molecules. And how it can be shown? It can be shown in this way: glucose plus oxygen. What I told you, glucose, that is C6H12O6 plus oxygen, means in presence of oxygen, it gives carbon dioxide plus water plus what? Energy. How? Energy. That is 38 ATP. Okay? This reaction is for aerobic respiration. This reaction is for aerobic respiration. Now let us see the reaction of anaerobic respiration. What I told you that here oxygen is not present, so glucose alone breaks down say ethyl alcohol or lactic acid. Ethyl alcohol plus carbon dioxide, that is CO2, plus energy, that is how much? 2 ATP. 2 ATP. Clear now? Okay. So, what is the difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration? When I talk about aerobic respiration, it takes place in the presence of oxygen, and anaerobic respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen. Aerobic respiration leads to complete oxidation of food, and anaerobic respiration leads to incomplete oxidation of food. Aerobic respiration occurs in cytoplasm and mitochondria, and anaerobic respiration occurs in cytoplasm. Clear? Aerobic respiration results in the formation of carbon dioxide and water as byproducts. Okay? And anaerobic respiration results in the formation of ethyl alcohol in plants or lactic acid in animals and carbon dioxide as byproduct. Okay? In aerobic respiration, 38 ATP molecules are produced, and in anaerobic respiration, 2 ATP molecules are produced. So this was about types of respiration. There are two types, aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Now, in our next class, we'll study about respiration in plants. Thank you, students.